各位同学好，我是林威老师，讲解经济学杂志已经8年的时间。这礼拜我们挑选的文章导读示范呢，介绍的是大坝，不过不是三峡大坝、雅斯文大坝，而是文艺复兴大坝。各位看到这边重要的三个国家，埃及、伊索比亚和苏丹，要学会共处，如何共享尼罗河水。我们把这段文章贴到我们讲解的位置。学英文听说读写非常重要，当然啦，翻译也是很重要的，尤其各位功力不足，有些时候 Google 翻译你看出现那些奇怪的用法，甚至有时候看了问号更多，这时候有老师的讲解会比较好。我先把这三句跟各位说明一下吧。首先我们先看 bluster， bluster 这是双关语，听听看它的发音
bluster，
咆哮，气势汹汹地说，风的呼啸，那不就太小，这个水从这个高度往低度流的时候，这个声音吗？ bluster 就这样变来的。再来他说这三个国家学会共处尼罗河水，尼罗河该怎么念呢？这是各位该背的 squabble， 它翻得很好，争吵，不过说或争吵的水听不懂，应该是说呢，这边学会的要么就共处，要么就吵得乱七八糟，到底呢结果就是这个水的资源问题会变得越来越糟。因为在这边的话你要弄清楚，就叫 squabble over water， 为水吵的事情最后变得越来越脏。脏什么意思啊？情况变得更糟糕，就越吵越严重，所以这边你看争吵的水可能变得更糟，它完全翻译的顺序是不对的。首先我们刚说要先听朗读吗？各位同学听听看，注意哦，听了每个字的咬字和发音。
Dam bluster. Egypt, Ethiopia and Sudan must learn how to share the Nile River. Or a squabble over water could turn nastier. Leaders. Once completed, the Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam will be nearly twice as tall as the Statue of Liberty and as wide as the Brooklyn Bridge is long. The reservoir behind it is roughly the size of London. Sitting on the Blue Nile, the main tributary of the Nile River, the dam is the largest hydroelectric project in Africa.Soon it will produce 6,000 megawatts of electricity, more than double Ethiopia's output today. With a little cooperation between Ethiopia and its downstream neighbors, Egypt and Sudan, the dam could be a boon for the whole region. Yet so far it has produced only acrimony. Egypt, which depends on the Nile for 90% of its fresh water, sees the dam as an existential threat.Shortly after construction began in 2011, officials in Cairo considered sabotage, a former president even considered bombing it. Last month, Ethiopia accused Egypt of sponsoring cyber attacks to disrupt the project.
各位同学听完了有没有开始更挫折了？好多单字听不懂啊，譬如说文艺复兴这个字你没有背过，或者是 acrimony 你也不明白，一个单字任何的单字都会卡住，甚至还有复合词，就是搭配词叫 existential threat， 这么多种种的单词用法会瞬间考验你的理解速度，甚至简单到 Statue of Liberty。 好，我们先针对两个单字来讲解吧。我们先看这个单字文艺复兴。文艺复兴各位知道吗？它从法语变来的，这个在法语就很 Renaissance。 那你要先知道 Renaissance 什么意思啊？我们那时候就要听法语老师讲、La date de Renaissance， Renaissance 就代表出生诞生， date 就是 date， 代表你的生日是多少，生日是哪一天呢、啊、所以这代表重生了。我们听听看它英文单字的发音
Renaissance
代表文艺复兴，就是这个单词就是代表是文艺复兴大坝，我取得非常的名称非常的好，所以学习英文本来就是要老师帮忙嘛，这才能学得好学得快。同样这个单词各位看住应该也会卡住了，我们来看字典林文老师提供的说法吧。你要背这个单词你要从这个字来思考，在荧幕上你看看这个单词就是非常的重要。首先 reservation， 但是你又不太明白怎么会有这个用法呢，所以这就是我们学英文最重要的地方。我们在英文在荧幕上看看它的用法，将将出来了 reservoir。 那至于这些单字有什么共通点，这就是老师教书最重要的地方，让你背一个单字的时候是一个一个慢慢背的，累积的背的最最重要，不然任何的小单字一看就卡住，一看就卡住，你不觉得这样浪费学习时间吗？那经济学人适合什么的程度，我再说一遍，中上的程度，至少多益要有600以上，这是必须具备的能力，而且会有点辛苦，700是最好的，特别是考托福啦研究所。各位，这个位在荧幕上我看到林文老师讲解的文章速度已经有多少了，已经有1930篇文章了，而且不断的往前迈进，8年全台湾就只有我讲解。想听更多优质的内容讲解吗？来找林文老师了，礼拜六晚上还有直播的 New York Times 的课程，以及每个月BBC 的课程也开了2年半。最后把这一段朗读再听一遍吧，听不懂单字很正常，功力不够嘛，找我咯，拜拜。
Dam bluster. Egypt, Ethiopia and Sudan must learn how to share the Nile River. Or a squabble over water could turn nastier. Leaders. Once completed, the Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam will be nearly twice as tall as the Statue of Liberty and as wide as the Brooklyn Bridge is long. The reservoir behind it is roughly the size of London. Sitting on the Blue Nile, the main tributary of the Nile River, the dam is the largest hydroelectric project in Africa. Soon it will produce 6,000 megawatts of electricity, more than double Ethiopia's output today. With a little cooperation between Ethiopia and its downstream neighbors, Egypt and Sudan, the dam could be a boon for the whole region. Yet so far it has produced only acrimony. Egypt, which depends on the Nile for 90% of its fresh water, sees the dam as an existential threat. Shortly after construction began in 2011, officials in Cairo considered sabotage, a former president even considered bombing it. Last month, Ethiopia accused Egypt of sponsoring cyber attacks to disrupt the project.